Today, we're going to create a custom wallpaper on Affinity Photo for iPad. The first thing we need to do is create a new document. If you're going to use this design as a wallpaper for your iPad, you'll want to set the document size to fit your iPad screen. Luckily, Affinity Photo comes with preset sizes for iPads. Just press on Photo, and then select Device. Now you can choose a preset size to use. Since I'm using a 12.9-inch iPad Pro, I'll select that preset. Now we can start our document, so press OK at the bottom. I'm going to zoom out a little so I can see my document better. Now we're going to make the background for our wallpaper. To do this, select the rectangle tool and then tap and drag to make a rectangle going across the document. To give our rectangle a more interesting color, let's use the fill tool to make a gradient. We'll make a gradient go all the way across our rectangle. If you hold down one finger, you can keep your gradient in a straight line. We're going to use three colors in our gradient. To add another color to the gradient, just press on the gradient line. I'll add another color to the center. Now we're going to change the colors of each one of our color stops. Let's start with the color stop on the right side. Just press on the color stop to select it, and then open the Color Studio. Then we can change its color to whatever we want. I'm going to make mine a dark gray. Now, let's give the left side of our gradient the same color. To do this, press on the left color stop to select it, and then we can give it the exact same color as the right color stop by using our recent colors. Finally, let's select the color in the middle of our gradient and make it a little darker. Now we can close the Color Studio by pressing on its icon again. If you want to learn more about gradients, we cover them in greater depth in the Color chapter of our Beginner's Guide to Affinity Photo. You can check out the complete guide in the video description if you want to learn more. The next part of our project will be making the shapes that our photo will go inside of. I'm going to use triangles for this design, but you can use any shapes you want. To make our triangles, I'm going to use the polygon tool. To get the polygon tool, press twice on the rectangle tool, and then select polygon at the bottom of the list. As a side note, we're using the polygon tool instead of the triangle tool because the polygon tool can make equilateral triangles, while the triangle tool makes isosceles triangles. I like the way equilateral triangles look better, so I'm going to stick with the polygon tool. Now, we just need to tap and drag to make a shape. And if you hold down one finger while dragging out the shape, you can keep its width and height equal. Then, we just need to change the number of sides to 3 in the context toolbar. If you want, you can change the color of your triangle from the Color Studio. It doesn't really matter what color it is though, since it's going to be covered up by our photo anyways, but it helps me personally to see it better if I change its color to something different than the background color. Then, we can use the Move tool to reposition our triangle to the center. To add more triangles, I'm going to duplicate the one we already have. To do this, have the triangle selected, and then press and hold anywhere on the screen. Then press Duplicate. With our new triangle, I'm going to resize and position it. Just remember to hold down one finger while resizing the object to keep its width and height equal. I'll also rotate it 180 degrees by tapping and dragging on the circle above the triangle. You can hold down one finger to keep your rotation in 15-degree increments, which makes it a lot easier to rotate it exactly 180 degrees. I'm going to continue this process to make a few more triangles. Once you're fully satisfied with how your shapes are looking, We're going to group them in the Layer Studio. Just swipe on each layer to select it, and then press on the Group button at the top of the studio. Then, we're going to rasterize this group. Be warned though, because this will take away your ability to edit the individual shapes, so really make sure you have them in the right spot. To rasterize the group, press on the Layer Options button, and then press Rasterize. Now, we have a pixel layer that we can use to hold our photo. To place a photo in the document, come to the Commands menu, and then press on Place. Then select the photo from wherever you have it saved. You can use any picture you want, but if you'd like to use the same image as me, I've left a download link in the video description. Once you've selected the photo, just tap and drag to place it. Now we're going to put the photo inside of our shapes. To do this, come to the Layer Studio and then tap and drag on the photo's layer and place it on top of the shapes layer. You can let go once you see a blue line running across the shapes. This makes our photo a child layer to the shapes layer, so the photo will only be visible where the shapes are. To learn more about child layers, please refer to our beginner's guide to Affinity Photo in the video description. If you want to continue resizing or positioning the photo, you can select its layer and then use the Move tool. You can also select the entire group, which allows you to move and resize the shapes and photo at the same time. Next, we're going to add some layer effects to our shapes. Make sure you have the group selected, and then come to the Layer Effects Studio. From here, we'll turn on Outer Shadow and 3D. Now, we're going to customize each one of these effects. Press on Outer Shadow, and then you can increase the radius, offset, and intensity from the context toolbar. You can turn this effect on and off whenever you want by pressing on the switch inside of the Layer Effects Studio. We can also press on 3D and then modify its settings from the context toolbar. I'm going to increase the depth and then add a little bit of softening. At this point, you can export your work and save it as a custom wallpaper for your iPad. Thanks for watching, my friends, and I'll see you in the next Affinity Revolution tutorial.